Days Gone is an action-adventure horror game set in a post-apocalyptic landscape 2 years after global pandemic. You, as a player, follow the story of Deacon St. John, a former member of a biker gang. He even has a mysterious military background. Well, what can I say? First thing is that I don't get it. I don't get how people could get their reviews out. Like, couple of days after the official launch. It's ridiculous because I'm still playing the game and I haven't finished it completely yet. And I now feel comfortable enough to put out a review because I now know enough. But let's get into Days Gone. Well, what can I say? We have a solid third-person open-world zombie game. The funnest part is that I expected nothing from this game because this year has been a disappointment to me so much times already. And I don't care what any SJW says, people who only played 10 hours of this game and then made a complaint of this game is not politically correct. Well, they can just take this game and put it deep into their vaginas. So, Days Gone is a package of everything. Solid story that keeps you engaged throughout tens upon tens of hours. A large open world map. Monstrous amounts of activities and collectibles, decent and motivating leveling system, and quite elaborate tuning possibilities for your bike. Now, where do I begin? So most of the world is in ruins and dead. Survivors have to set up camps and outposts throughout the Origin County. The main protagonist, Deacon, is a drifter who finds himself running errands between them. While trying to help others, he soon wants to learn about why and how this world is overrun by half-dead humanoids that strongly resemble ghouls from Fallout 76. And while doing that, even a glimpse of hope that his long-lost wife might be still alive keeps Deacon going. The behavior of the creatures in this world, from intellectual perspective, varies a lot, as some are more animal-like, and Reapers tend to be more like humans, meaning that some can talk and use weapons, or at least want to be more creature-like. Some are dumber than my kitchen stool. Some even look like children who climb on the rooftops. Many form huge groups, or hordes, and attack you. You not only battle against freakers, you also are at war with bandits, animals, and other weird mutated creatures. What about the graphics and sound? Well, I really like the overall look of Days Gone. Graphically, it's beautiful. Landscape-wise and weather-wise, the game excels and ticks every box. As it rains, you see puddles forming. As it snows, you see that the nature gets gradually covered with snow, and every footprint is going deeper and deeper as the snow continues to pile. It's exceptionally well done. Day and night cycle, plus the weather elements, really bring this game alive. But facial animations, you know, reactions from NPCs are just ridiculous. The red rubber face, like, it's not beautiful. They are reactionless, to say the least. They are like faces with a lot of Botox.
And then from the eyebrows down, dead.
Even though the voiceovers are done marvelously, the animation is just beyond shallow. But considering the amount of characters and narrative behind everything, it's totally acceptable, as the game is good. Now, the annoying part of this game is the amount of glitches, but luckily none of them have been game-breaking. I have had a couple of crashes though. Some enemies might materialize in front of you, and I don't mind it as long as they are materializing in front of me as I'm driving. In Days Gone, you have your trusty motorcycle that will help you in your travels around the world. You need fuel, you need parts to keep it moving, so that incentivizes you to look under every bonnet and collect as much loot as you can, because you will need it for everything. Besides upgrading, tuning and mending your bike, you also have a crafting system for medicine, weapons and explosives. You can also upgrade your weapons by using these materials. Bullets, weapons and fuel can be bought, but most of the time you are in the wilderness and there is no way to get to your camp. Every camp or outpost has their own currency and trust levels as well. You need both to purchase newer weapons, and you need them separately in every camp, meaning that all the camps do not sell the same items, so you need to level them up by doing quests. I don't really grasp the point why you need to have separate currency between all the outposts. I mean, that's just me. But otherwise, I see the point of trust level in every camp separately. So I don't know, that is kind of weird for me. Most of the quests in this game are fetching, sneaking and eavesdrop related. There are occasional chases and shootings as well, but all those are masked under this interesting narrative, and most of them are really rewarding as well. The game itself is long. Minimum time of Platinum Trophy is about 60 hours, but if you want to enjoy the game, it will be around 80 hours for sure. Now, this game has multiple difficulty settings, but I found it to be challenging, in a good way, even on easy settings. Some perks you unlock let you see through walls and make the game easier, but the element of surprise when you are being attacked is very fun prior to this unlock. As good as this game is, there are still bugs and glitches in it, but the worst thing that you encounter in Days Gone are not enemies, are not the mutated creatures, but it's the quick menu weapon wheel. That has to be one of the worst things I have ever used. It's like making whipped cream with your penis. It's like using your power drill to bang the nails in the wall. It's as abnormal as seeing a hippo give a birth to a man. As you use your analog controller, you select the explosive selection, which opens 2, 3, or 4 options between those explosives. This requires you to move your analog controller in another direction to choose between them. Thus, you have a chance that the explosive menu might close and magically appear in your weapon selection. This happens at least once every time you use this menu. It's ridiculous and heinous to use. But overall, this game is fantastic. It's a surprise in the mists of flying rhino shit that hovered towards me in the past 4 months. And of course, Days Gone is a home to horde killing as well. I mean, killing those hordes might be difficult, it takes some time, but it's rewarding to kill those thousands of zombies. They're not zombies in this game. They are zombies, but they're not zombies. So, it's easy and fun platinum, no questions about that. I give this game a 7.5 out of 10, with no regrets. Get this game, play this game, enjoy this game. I hope that you enjoyed this review. If you did, hit that like, smash that bell, and if you dare, subscribe as well. I'm Silly Llamas, and thanks for watching. Till next time.